Coastal Carolina has a 3-1 mark in 2011. Good Sunday. This is the David Bennett Show. I'm Rich Krampanis. We come to you from Greensboro, North Carolina, on the campus of North Carolina A&T. Coach David Bennett, an impressive effort by your Chanticleers. Certainly a huge bounce back from last week against Georgia.
Yeah, you know, I was a little worried about our offense. We hadn't scored in three halves, Rich, but offense, we missed some opportunities early. We got 17 points in the first half, got another one to start the second half to go up 24. Then our defense relaxed a little bit, and we gave up a 17-play drive to North Carolina A&T, and then had a freaky play on a punt where it hit one of our young men in the head, and Tyler McCarthy, and they recovered it, punched in another one. I said, good gracious. So, and then our offense got another one to go up 31-14. It was much needed, Rich.
Let's take you through all the steps and the twists and turns from Saturday afternoon in Greensboro, North Carolina. Here's the highlights between the Chanticleers and North Carolina A&T. Great afternoon in Greensboro, North Carolina, Coach, for a 4 o'clock kickoff.
Yeah, and they had rain all week long, Rich. They couldn't hardly paint their field until Saturday morning.
Good job by the defense's first play from scrimmage, Andre Jacobs, along with Jeffrey Sally.
Yep, Jeffrey Sally had the feist in there at nose guard, who's undersized but got a big old heart. Defense played pretty good most of the day, Rich, except for, I know, one drive there. Good play by Marcus Lott, breaking on the ball right there, forcing them to punt.
And, Coach, the offense got going on its second possession. A key play here, Aramis Hillary to Matt Hazel.
Great job by Matt Hazel. Aramis underthrew him a couple of times. First play of the game, we tried to go deep, but glad to see Matt Hazel get some catches and have a great day for us. It's a good field goal here by Grant Clayton, a hole by Austin Kane, snap by Shane Ballard, but it's a little low. We got to get it a little harder. They hadn't cut that grass in over a week, so it was a mighty high bit of grass there, Rich.
Time now for the Coastal Ice cool play of the game, and it was a real unit effort by the defense on this interception.
Yeah, it's a great play. Trey Henderson here on the contact. Ball comes out, goes to Derek Frazier. And Frazier hangs on right there. They got him jerking our guy down. Come on right there, officials. Y'all need to be right there on top of that.
See the bang-bang play here. It is Trey Henderson right here that causes the fumble. That thing pops out, and Derek Frazier takes care of the rest.
Great job right there getting a turnover. Good hit by Trey, and good job by Derek Frazier being what the old guys used to say, Johnny on the spot.
Johnny on the spot indeed. Some more Coastal defense and some more Derek Frazier.
Yes, sir. And our linebackers do a great job of rolling in there. They do a great job of rolling.
So Coastal Carolina with a 3-0 lead at this point. And Coach, I'm sure you were excited to see the offense get going here on this drive.
Yep, great air on the ball. We caught that ball. Boy, look at Jamie Childers catch it. That official said he was juggling it. No, sir, that was a great catch. Look at y'all's coverage right here. Never came off. Great job. Who shot that? You were it.
That was me down low, Coach. I'll take the kudos there.
Great shot. Should have been a completion. Good play here by Andre Jacobs. Great tackle from behind.
And then Chris Floyd here on a little dump route.
Yep, good job here by Chris. Take care of that ball. A few punches right there. Good job getting that thing down there in the teal zone for us. Lower Timmy. Lower Tim Franklin. Great play by Aramis, flipping the ball to Marcus Whitener, getting the ball just inside the 10-yard line here, Rich.
And it's going to set up a third down situation, Coach, and we're going to see a beautiful ball from Hillary to Matt Hazel.
I'm telling you what a great throw and catch by Matt Hazel going up in double coverage to get a touchdown right there. We didn't score some points in the first quarter, but had a much better second quarter, Rich.
Deserves another look on our Walkabout Land and Timber Shots Rewind, Coach. This one was pretty. I was lucky to get the best view in the house for this one.
Beautiful coverage. Thank you to the Henson boys for sponsoring the Walkabout Land and Timber Rewind. And again, got to get some points. You're on the road, or anytime, Rich, you need to get some points when you can get them.
How about some special teams play here, Coach?
Great coverage right here. Great footage of a block punt. Tyler McCarthy and Deshaun Davis. Tyler, don't leave your feet. We can't wait to show them this in the team meeting. Don't leave your feet. Take it off the foot, and it's a good job blocking it, but it might have gone backwards towards the goal line if you hadn't left your feet.
Coach, you really threw the ball downfield well in this game, and Chris Pressley with a great catch here.
Yeah, Coach Brown and our offensive staff worked more this week on taking some chances down, you know, deep, and just did a good job here. Take care of that ball, Aramis. Good job. That's a good job of reading the option. What it is, it's just a little gun option right there, Rich.
Coach, I've been waiting a long time to say this. Travis Small is in the end zone for the Chanticleers.
Yep, Travis got a nose for that goal line, was a great running back at Chirawa High School, and so glad for Travis. I believe that's his first college touchdown right
there,
Rich.
Sure is. Great job by Travis Small. 17-0 Coastal. And, Coach, the defense in the first half was stellar. This is Chris Thomas, CT, with a sack.
Great job by CT. Yeah, I thought our defense did an outstanding job, other than third quarter, letting them have a 17-play drive. Halftime, I'm telling you, what a show. North Carolina A&T's band is just outstanding. 220 members in their band, Rich.
Just a treat to get to listen to them at halftime. It's tough to get some work done when you hear them play.
And they play most the entire game. I don't know how they have that energy. They do a great job. Great job, great throw and catch here on third and mighty long. It's third and 20 to Jamie Childers. Jamie did a great job at tight end for us there.
That one picked up about 30 yards, and this was a fantastic drive, Coach.
Yes, sir. Go low. Go low, Jamal Boswell. You're 215. There's no DB that weighs 215. Run with fierce tempo. Just get your rear end low. Good job here by Marcus Whitener, getting low, getting behind your pads rather than being high.
And Whitener will get in the end zone. Second touchdown pass by Hillary. 24-0 Coastal.
Great job by our offense with the first possession of the second half, getting a score. Now let's go. Let's don't let up. We don't need to let up here, Rich. We don't need to be too nice out there.
But North Carolina A&T, the Aggies, do put together an impressive drive. 17 plays to get on the board is 24-7.
Give them credit. They did a great job, but there's no way we should let somebody take a 17-play drive on us. We got to have something happen in there.
Good play here by Adrian Sullivan.
Keep your feet there, Adrian. Keep your feet. Good play. Our little boy Jeb coming home said, that number 81. He and Mac, a young man living with us for a year, said, that guy can fly. He's got to keep him up. He had some nice plays in the ball game.
More good Coastal defense.
Good play by Dontavious. He's in man coverage. He doesn't see the ball thrown, but didn't interfere with him. Just great job right there. The closer you are to a guy, harder it is to catch the ball.
And, Coach, here's just some simple bad luck. The ball, you won't see it here, but it hits Tyler McCarthy in the helmet.
Yeah, that right there where Nicolo's got to be very vocal and say, you know, get away from the ball, get away, get away. And it hit Tyler McCarthy in the head. I thought it hit them, but they ruled it hit our guy in the head. Can't advance a muff on a kick there. So they gave him the ball, and they scored and made it 24-14.
But, Coach, I thought the response by the offense might be the most impressive part of this game. It's getting tight, 24-14. Two big plays starting with this one by Adrian Sullivan.
Great play right there. Great job. And our offensive line did a great job. And I hope we get another angle here. Look at Pat Williams, our center, number 66, pulling around right here.
Don't forget about Mo Ashley and Tim Franklin.
Mo and Tim Franklin, right, great job. Boom, look right there by Pat Williams. That sprung that play, got it down to about the plus 30. Huge play, huge play. And then we run a little play. We can't tell you the name of it, but it's a play where we read the option to give or pull based on the five technique. Aramis can run the ball or he can throw the ball. Over here to our X receiver. Good job blocking by Jamal Boswell. He throws it to Matt Hazel. Matt accelerates great right here. Cuts inside of him. Takes that thing all the way to the house.
33 yards for Matt Hazel. Second touchdown of the game for the sophomore. And Coach, we'll take another look at this one, and the play fake really works here.
Well, he's reading that thing. You see, they took him. So he reads it, he pulls it, he can run it or throw it, he throws it to Matt. Take care of that ball, Matt. Keep it on your ribs. Keep it on your ribs. Great job here by Matt getting us to 31 points.
Coach, something happened on the extra point here. Brian Brooks would get ejected from the game, and I know you got a little pretty upset about this.
Yeah, you know, he can't retaliate, even though they did something at first, and I'm just telling them right there that, hey, they kicked our guy. You know, they hit our guy while he's down on the ground. And, you know, you can't have that. Right here, I think I'd get a little bit close to him. All I did was say, they kicked our guy. And he said, Coach, you crossed the line. I told him, I said, buddy, you better be able to stand the heat in the kitchen because it's a tough, fierce game.
And, Coach, you stood up for your players. That's the most important thing to see from that video right there. And Marcus Whitener running out the clock and an impressive Coastal Carolina victory in this one.
Yep, you got to be able to run the ball, especially at the end of the game if you have a lead. Got to be able to run the ball. Coach Broadway, you see right here from North Carolina A&T, class act. They made a great hire. They made a great hire at North Carolina A&T.
The Chanticleers go on to a 31-14 victory over North Carolina A&T. Coach, you got to be happy. 3-1 heading into the bye.
Yeah, if you told us at the beginning of the year, 3-1, getting ready for the bye week, getting ready for VMI, we'll take it.
Well, Coach, this is the first time this season that we had one quarterback at Coastal Carolina, and it was Aramis Hillary. Talk about that decision, and Aramis seemed comfortable running the offense the whole way through.
Yeah, and I think, you know, Jamie, again, selfless, will do whatever we ask. Jamie did a fantastic job at tight end. He and David Duran can both line up there. I thought he did a great job catching some balls and blocking. One time I saw him flatback a young man, and I said, good gracious, that's the aggression that people coming, you know, scouts want to see out of Jamie. And it's just, what can I do to help the team? And we're learning lessons daily. And Jamie did a great job. Aramis did some very good things as well.
But it's safe to say that Jamie's still very much in the mix of quarterback.
Yeah, Jamie can play quarterback if we need him to do that. We didn't need him to do that tonight, so we needed him to play tight end. And he did a good job.
A good job indeed as Coastal Carolina improves to 3-1 on the season with a 31-14 win over North Carolina A&T. Time for us to take a break. When we come back, we'll head back to Greensboro, North Carolina for post-game reaction. You're watching The David Bennett Show presented by HTC.
Waste Management presents Where Are They Now? A look back at former Coastal Carolina Chanticleers. Markell Willis was a wide receiver at Coastal Carolina from 2008 through 2010. So what is Markell up to now?
Right now I'm just helping out with the equipment staff, trying to help out a little bit, you know, help out where I can, wherever they need me to. Just getting ready to go to Green Bay. I'll be playing for the Green Bay Blizzard in February, so just trying to stay in shape and get ready for that.
Where Are They Now is presented by Waste Management, a proud sponsor of The David Bennett Show.
The David Bennett Show is brought to you by People's Underwriters with two locations in Conway and Carolina Forest. Visit peoplesunderwriters.com.
We're proud to have Coastal Ice as part of our team this year, providing ice to the PD and all over the Grand Strand.
We're proud to bring you the Coastal Ice cool play of the game. And when you think of ice, think of Coastal Ice and call 488 for ice.
Everyone at Coastal Ice wants to wish the Chanticleers the best of luck.
Coastal Ice says,
go Shots!
Locals love Creek Rats for dinner. They rave about the seafood dinner special. Baskets, po' boys, wraps, and burgers. When you experience those incredible waterfront views, you get that relaxed Creek Rats attitude. On the Marsh Walk in Merle's Inlet and on Celebration Lake in Florence.
My HTC digital cable service delivers all my favorite shows, movies, and sports entertainment. We always crack up watching comedies on video on demand and raise the roof cheering for our favorite sports teams in high def. HTC offers all the channels and features I love and connects me with the ones who mean the most.
NFL Network and NFL Red Zone provide the most extensive weekly coverage and put you in the action with every touchdown now available on HTC digital cable.
HTC, this is life. Connect with it.
Welcome back to the David Bennett Show. It's time to hear from Coach Bennett's staff and their thoughts on Saturday's game. This week's coordinator comments are being brought to you by Coca-Cola.
We started off a little slow, but I was real happy the way we came out in the second half, answered with a score, got the ball back after they answered with one, and we answered right back. So it was pretty good being mature and learning from our mistakes the first half and carrying it over to the second half adjustments.
Well, again, I was very proud of the way that we played the first half. I saw somewhere where they were like 38 yards total offense first half and no first downs. And I was mighty proud of them, but we just ended up not doing exactly what we didn't want to do as far as finishing up the ball game. Very proud of them. I'm very proud of what they did today. They set the tone. They played throughout. But, again, I wish we had finished the game like we started it.
The good thing is we have an open week this week. We're going to go back and dissect what we've done from week zero to through now and go back to the drawing board and let's see if we can't get a little bit better.
Yeah, for our coordinators, I'm sure all of them got some things we need to improve on, and it's fun to improve on a win rather than having to improve on a loss. So proud of our coordinators and the job our staff did. Glad we're going to have a week off to get ready for a very much improved VMI team on October the 8th, Brooks Stadium, Benton Field.
Let's jump into the stats right now, Coach, and taking a look at the overall numbers. Pretty even on time of possession, but when it comes down to it, 384 to 194. Good job by the offense. Good job by the defense.
Yeah, 200 more yards by our offense than North Carolina A&T. But I'm going to tell you this. Coach Broadway was a phenomenal hire for North Carolina A&T. They've had some scholarship limitations. They will be back up. They will build a championship program at North Carolina A&T with Coach Broadway.
Taking a look at some of the individual numbers, Aramis Hillary, 18 to 24. He is awfully efficient for 255 yards. Three touchdowns, more importantly, no interceptions. Matt Hazel, six catches for 92 yards and two scores.
Matt had two scores. One of them was in double coverage. Another one, he hit another gear. And Adrian Sullivan helped set up that touchdown. That was a big drive for us there in the fourth quarter to get that extra touchdown to go up 31.
And after the game, we caught up with the terrific duo, Hillary and Hazel.
You know, we just had a lot, you know, came in with a little chip on our shoulder, you know, just being shut down. But, you know, we just came in, you know, we had to get some points on the board. That was the first thing. And, you know, after that, the offense just got rolling.
I think it took our confidence way up, man. We moved on to 3-1. The offense, you know, put up some points today. So that's a real good start for us going into the conference. But, like I said, we just got to keep working, man. Everybody's real motivated. Everybody's real excited about this season. So we're just going to keep working and keep moving forward.
Just as the offense, we just tired of it. It always seeming like we don't carry our end of the game. You know, like seeing like the defense always got to carry us. And it's just like we want to come out and carry our weight. So we came out with the mindset we was going to put some points on the board, and we did it.
Yeah, so that's one of our goals every week, man. We try to come out here and play good defense against all the teams. That's one of our goals every week. Actually, it started off with the defensive line because the defensive line didn't get pressure and the linebackers weren't in there on right positions, and if the corners weren't in the right positions, nobody would have got the pick. Great job by Trey by punching the ball out when he was making the tackle, and I was just there to make the ball, just catch the ball.
Our HCC peak performer from the North Carolina A&T game, Matt Hazel, the sophomore from North Augusta, six catches, 92 yards, two touchdowns, Coach.
Yep, couple of underthrows that Matt had a chance to catch earlier in the game. He didn't get them. He hurt his hand a little bit. I told him, next week's open date week. You can rest your hand all next week. Very proud of Matt. His daddy was all smiles after the game.
It's time now for our injury report brought to you each and every week by our good friends at Conway Medical Center. Coach, a few names on the board.
Yep, we got a few banged up, and appreciate Conway Medical Center for sponsoring our injury report. And hopefully with an off week, we can get them well and get them healthy for VMI October the 8th.
Time for us to take a break. When we come back, it's time for Sean's Corner. The coach goes one-on-one with quarterback tight end Jamie Childers. That's where the David Bennett Show continues right after this. The David Bennett Show is brought to you by Waste Management, Coastal Orthopedic and Strand Orthopedic, Coca-Cola, Crescent Bank, and Shred Alert.
Shred Alert owner Adam Parnes says, don't compromise the integrity of your personal and financial documents, shred them. Shredding is important in order to prevent identity theft, one of the fastest growing crimes in the U.S. Don't be a victim. Shred Alert has served professional, residential, and government offices from Georgetown to Wilmington since 2002 and has been recognized for being the document destruction company of the Grand Strand and surrounding areas. So whether it's paper, uniforms, or any sensitive materials, Shred Alert of Myrtle Beach is the only choice to get the job done. Contact us today.
All right, guys, it's crunch time. The game's on the line. You've played great so far, but you got to finish the job. You got to finish the job. You're the team everybody wants to be. Come on, guys. Let's go show them why we're the champs.
Right now, get the longest-lasting, most versatile, and most fuel-efficient lineup in America at Palmetto Chevrolet. No one has more Consumer Digest Best Buys for the 2010 model year than Chevrolet. Coastal Carolina Chanticleers and Palmetto Chevrolet, a winning combination.
And nobody beats a Palmetto deal.
In life, there is a common thread that binds us. It's not always something we can see, or hear, or touch. The connection that brings us together as people. People who feel that technology adds up to more than just wires and plastic. But the thread that binds us together in the most important facet of our lives, connecting with it. HTC. This is life. Connect with it.
Welcome back to the David Bennett Show. It's time now for Sean's Quarter, brought to you by HTC. This is life. Connect with it.
With Jamie Childers here. Jamie, question number one. Growing up, who was the biggest influence on your life?
Growing up, my parents influenced me the most. They're always there for me and helped me through tough times.
To date, what's your best memory of Coastal Carolina?
My best memory to date is winning the Big South Championship last year, and waited a long time for that, and I'm ready to get another one this year.
Okay. If you had a mulligan, if you had a redo in life, what's something you would change?
Well, I would play the lottery and see the numbers and then go back and play it again after I already knew the numbers.
Okay. Last question for you. Well, we got two more. You hear the phrase game day. What do you think of when you hear game day?
I get excited. Get a chance to go out there and play the game I love.
Okay. And last question, or last thing for you, pick one coach on our staff and imitate that coach the best you can.
I'm not falling into that trap.
Anybody?
Coach Hammer, I'm going to be running sprints.
Coach James, come on.
I'll do one.
All right.
Drugs, alcohol, guns, women. Mix any one of the four, deadly combination.
Okay. Here we are, the Brown Locker Room, Atkins Fieldhouse, Sean's Corner. Thanks for joining us.
The David Bennett Show is brought to you by Bojangles, the Britton Law Firm, and Coastal Ice.
A&I over the years, we've had working relationships. They've handled fires, water losses, wind losses. They've been there for us so that we could be there for our clients. Their professionalism, their follow-up, it has been absolutely flawless. If everybody did the work as they promised to do, like A&I does, we'd be in real good shape in this town.
When disaster strikes, we're the ones to call. A&I does it all.
Locals love Greek Rats for lunch. They say it's the fresh salads, fantastic wraps, and seafood baskets. But when you experience those incredible waterfront views, you get that relaxed Greek Rats attitude. On the Marsh Walk in Merrill's Inlet and on Celebration Lake in Florence.
Coastal Carolina University Chanticleers need to concentrate on playing their best, not worrying about what to do if an injury occurs. As Strand Orthopedic Consultants and Coastal Orthopedic Associates, we offer all our patients comprehensive orthopedic care from our team of renowned specialists. So no matter what your game, you can stay on top of it. Strand Orthopedic Consultants and Coastal Orthopedic Associates, proud to be the team physicians of the Coastal Carolina University Chanticleers and sponsors of the Dave Bennett Coaches Show.
In life, there is a common thread that binds us. It's not always something we can see or hear or touch, but rather something we can feel. The thread that binds us together in the human experience. To know the exhilaration of achievement, the sorrow of a lost love, to truly connect with those things which make up our lives. As families, as friends, as romantics, as people. People who feel that technology adds up to more than just wires and plastic. But the thread that binds us together in the most important facet of our lives, connecting with it. HTC. This is life. Connect with it.
It's time for a Bojangles blast from the past. October 27th, 2007 in Conway. CCU hosting the VMI Key Dance. Mike Tolbert was a man possessed. Big Mike ran for a school record 244 yards. Tolbert helped Coastal rally for 21 fourth quarter points with the game winner coming on this 86-yard touchdown run. 42-35, Coastal wins a thriller over VMI. Blast from the Past is brought to you by your Grand Strand Bojangles, proud sponsors of the David Bennett Show.
Coach, no HTC scouting report this week because you have next week off.
Mm-hmm. We need it. We need that week off. We're, you know, glad we're 3-1 going into the bye week, knowing we had to go play Georgia and Athens. We'd take it. Rich would take that at the very beginning of the year, and glad we got a week to heal up. Practice on some fundamentals, cut out some missed assignments, where Matt Hazel's daddy said, run them boys, coach. Run them, get them in better shape. So, guys, we're going to run a little bit in the open week.
Thanks to Mr. Hazel. Doing a little bit of coaching there. So, no highlights next week, but I'm very excited about this show because for the open week edition of the David Bennett Show, we have a chance for you during the summer to catch up with some of your NFL players and give them a trip back in time, some of the great moments in their history.
Yep, very proud of those guys, and You know, Tyler's given back and named the quarterback meeting room, and so proud of those guys. And we've got to get some more in there. We got a couple guys this year who got a chance, and we'll have to see what happens down the road, Rich.
Here's a sneak peek at what we have next week on the David Bennett Show.
The number two simp moment.
Interception.
This was triple overtime. You pick it here, hang on.
I wasn't down right there either. Did you see that? My knee never touched the ground.
Yeah, but you know, we're on their field. We ain't going to get that call.
Yeah.
We're not going to get that.
We're going to get those calls anyway.
Nice TFL right here. A little flare pass by Liberty. I remember won this in three overtimes. Mm-hmm. Here, this is against South Carolina State, 05, I believe. Pick right here to seal the game, isn't it?
Yep.
Simp on you. That's a great pick. That was a great win. The next year, they come back here, and you block a punt.
Oh, yeah. Me and Braden had a trying to go to get the most blocks in the season, and I finally beat him.
You didn't get hurt, did you?
No, I got kicked. It'll be all right.
That was a big crowd that day. Nice hit right there. What'd you say to him right there?
I was talking to him. He was talking to me all game, talking about how I wasn't going to do nothing. And I said, if I get a chance, I'm going to get you. And I got him right there.
Top fig moments, Tyler. Top five plays in your career. But I tell you what, the first one's at Walford. That was a great win there. He's about to catch you here, isn't he?
Yeah, he was. I think about ran out of gas. I think that was right around the fourth quarter.
What happened right here? Like, did you about cramp up?
Yeah, I think I caught a cramp right there. But I tell you what a game that was. We still talk about that when the guys come around. I'll be honest with you. It gave me a lot of chills just reminiscing those old times and talking about them. What a great 4 or 5 years I had here at Coastal. And, I made a lot of memories. And it's always nice to – when you see other guys that talk about those memories that we were able to just watch there on TV.
Yeah, Rich, as you can see, our guys have become a lot more knowledgeable, and the knowledge of the game has expanded with them being in the NFL, and very, very proud of those guys. And Mike Tolbert, when that cats and dogs thing hit, Mike Tolbert and Tyler, all those guys were texting and saying, Coach, LOL, that's just every day at Coastal Carolina. And I said, that's what it is. That's every day.
And we are looking forward to next week to spend some time with some of the all-time great Coastal Carolina football players. That's next week, Sunday at noon, right here on News Channel 15. Coach, congratulations on a great win. And I know you'll be working hard, but enjoy a little bit of time off during this bye week.
Thank you, Rich. Appreciate the job y'all do, 15, traveling with us. And Ed Piotrowski, we appreciate him being such a great, what do you call it, photographer? Or when you shoot?
Yeah.
What's it called?
We'll call him a videographer.
Videographer. And Ed, I think you might have Billy Huggins beat. I think you got him beat.
It was Billy Huggins' birthday on Friday.
Happy birthday, Billy.
Well, we want to thank you for making us part of your Sunday each and every week. We'll see you next week for the open week edition of the David Bennett Show. David Bennett Show is brought to you by Palmetto Chevrolet, A&I Fire and Water Restoration, Creek Rats, Conway Medical Center, and HTC, title sponsor of the David Bennett Show for the past 8 years.
Hello, I'm Tommy Britton. Along with my children, Case, Preston, and Mary Madison, I practice law here in Myrtle Beach. We're now known as the Britton Law Firm. We're all graduates of Walford College, but we're great supporters of David Bennett, Coastal Carolina football, and the great university Coastal Carolina has become. It's been a pleasure over the years to sponsor this program, the Britton Law Firm. All claims, trials in all courts.
Come get that relaxed Creek Rats attitude on the Marsh Walk in Merle's Inlet and overlooking Celebration Lake on South Cashua in Florence.
With my HTC wireless phone, I'm always connected to the world around me. Whether it's simple everyday things like a call from a friend, a text from my daughter, or even an update to my Facebook status while I'm out and about, HTC connects me with the things that mean the most.
HTC is your wireless headquarters for back to school. Get 3 months of HTC residential high-speed internet free with new HTC wireless service.
HTC, this is life. Connect with it.